So into the sheaf for aqueducts once again. Then it was this way, wasn't it? All sorts of sneaky sneaky, because these crucible knights can just bugger off. I've tried learning to parry them. On my off-camera character, the golden parry and everything, I've tried my best. And I just can't deal with them. So, yeah. I'm just ignoring them in general. Right, looks like friend D is buggered off somewhere. That's D2, that is. Aha. There he is. D, Beholder of Death. Come along then, D. Let's try and fight some Gargs. Oh, we've got Jarfriend as well. Although, again, the Gargs are probably immune to everything. But maybe they'll keep the Gargs off our back for a bit. Come on, friends. That's a good start. Now, what are you going to do? Knock me over again. Good. Well, have some of this. And one of those. And a bit of that. And now you're on fire, maybe. Wish you wouldn't move around so much. I can't really hit you if you move around all the time. But if you're staggered, then we can at least get an extra shot in there, so that's nice. And now your mate's coming in, so now it all gets horrible. Oh, and the poison. Just insta-kills us, because we can't get out of it in time. What a bunch of bullshit. So the Great Shield is good in this fight, it seems. But our lack of agility, bit of an issue. Not sure how much Jarve Wright was doing for us, but they seem pretty tanky, so that's good. So maybe this time, don't trap the boss in a corner. Although we didn't have a lot of choice in the map deciding where he wanted to go, so. Now he's over there. Not terribly worried about my runes. Yeah, if you're gonna just miss your attacks because I'm slightly down a hill, that's fine. Oh, there goes Jarre. Oh well. Stop being so bloody agile. Is this gonna be one of those things where the first attempt goes much better than any follow-ups? Come on, I was behind the wall. Oh, yep, first one's dead. Excellent stuff. Well done, D. Now we've just got one to deal with. Time not to screw this up, hopefully, because that went really well. So, yeah, there's the poison. Oh god, it hits behind him as well. Fuck off! So, okay, when he does the poison then, we just stay the hell away. Because it hits in front, it hits behind. It's cheap as all hell. And you can't even see it. But that's our new strat. Hang out by the cliff and wait for the gargoyles to throw themselves off. I don't care if it's cheesy. These guys are allegedly valiant, and yet they're trying to fight me 2-on-1. So, yeah, they can suck a big stony knob. Right, come on then, lads. Over to the corner. One of us is going off the cliff today. Hopefully it's the gargoyle.
Oh,
Womp. Yep, that's fine. We can tank that. And we can tank that too. Oh, we could have probably tanked that. If we were facing the right direction to block it. Now watch as he just completely fails to go off the cliff. Oh, soon poison. Back off, everyone. Although we want the crit, if we can. But we can't. Oh, and his mate's involved. Excellent. Oh shit, we poisoned again. Have we got enough for a flame cleanse? Maybe we have, good. Get our halberd out, please. Oh shit, we're in poison again. Didn't even see where that came from. But it's killing us. So, there we go. Now you're poisoning again. There goes Jar, right? Okay. Poison's worn off, good. Oh, piss. I didn't realise you had a hit on the rebound. No. Where you at? Oh, you're poisoning again. Now we're knocked over in the poison. Which means we're basically dead at this stage. Oh god, we survived. The boy lived. Now, which one do we want to kill? It's that guy at the back. Right. Fuck. Poisoned again. And dead. Yeah. Couldn't get away from the poison clouds again. Maybe D is not the answer. It just gives them too much health and doesn't take it down quickly enough to make it worthwhile, I don't think. Because that bit when they're both in the fight together is when we die horribly. Let's just see if we can't bait the first one off the cliff and then summon Jaro. That might be fun. Just try and tank all this shit. Oops. Okay, I tried to attack. That was a mistake. Oh, we nearly got him off.
Phrasing.
Oh, fuck. What happened there? And see ya. Okay, so the first one can be baited off the cliff without too much issue. We could probably try and do the same with the second one, but maybe we'll try and fight him properly. Maybe we'll let our Jar friend solo it. Poison. I think that's the gargoyle's poison rather than Jarrite's. Will you just stand still for one cotton picking session? Ah, shit, we're poisoned. And we are full poisoned and we're dead. One poison! One poison cloud is enough to kill a super tanky character. From full health. This fight is almost as bullshit as that one Trace did the other day. Almost. But yeah, we'll start with the same strat. We'll cheese the first one into falling off the cliff. And then maybe we'll just see if we can cheese the second one into falling off the cliff as well. Although I don't know if he has jumpy back attacks. If it wasn't for the poison, this fight would be fun, I think. Ta-ra-ra. It's pretty easy to bait that first one, I've got to say. Didn't expect jumping. Well, there you go. Now, what about you, my friend? Can we persuade you to jump as well? That's a big boy attack. Are you even going to jump back? I don't know if you are. You're going to hit me, that's fair, I suppose. We'll just run away from your bullshit. And yeah, maybe it's time for our own bullshit. Trying to get off this charge tattoo, so they're very effective when they land. But getting them to land is the trouble. Probably better off just using jumping R2s instead. Oh, how did you hit me there, you cheese? We also need to watch out for poison. Because the minute it comes in, one must back the hell away. Like now, for example. The fact that it hits you as well as poisoning you is just a joke. But, yeah, you've got some attacks that can be punished, so there is that. Looks up. Yep, you just do your thing. And we'll just come in for the kill, maybe? Now we're coming for the kill, maybe? Hey! You guys suck and I hate you. The Gargoyle's Greatsword and Twin Blade. We'll take those. Greatsword, pure strength and dex, fine. Twin Blade again, pure strength and dex. Cool. Do they have anything interesting to say about themselves? Nope. Just like the axe, mended with corpse wax, a patchwork of champions. Fair enough. Now we can have a sniff around old Leyendell. Now that Wes has had his first look that he deserves for getting here first. It's fair game for everyone, really. Although that said, I do want to pop down to the Eternal City. Before I forget. Because if I don't go down there and grab what we want, then, yeah, forgetting is exactly what will happen. Yeah, I've heard promising things about these great shield guys, and I've not tried them on anyone, but Lulu would love to have someone just tank for her while she fires dragon breath from behind. So that's our plan. I do love the whole spirit ash system. Anyone who's not using them for the extra challenge or just because they think it's cheap, they're missing out on a great deal of fun. Now it's eerily quiet down here. Have I noticed the lack of music down here before? I don't know if I have, because it's just struck me how quiet it is after being up there in Limgrave and just hearing the regular music for that area. Soporific grease. That could come in handy against a particular boss later on. Well, there's probably other ways. Non-consumable ways of trying to deal with the same boss. Oops, I thought botched that jump. Are we that worried about these lads? I don't think we are. Did one of them just fall off a cliff? We'll take it. And then do we want to do a proper explore of this area or not? We don't really need to. Right now, at least. Yeah, how is your great shield doing against my pure holy damage? It's not so hot, is it, lads? Alright, steady on. I guess taking on four of the buggers at once is a bit much. Now, kind of walked into that one. Wish the jumping attack was better on these fists. But they're pretty cool. They've got better range than most fists, which is great. Because that is my main trouble with fist weapons, in general. Now, it'd be nice if these buggers could drop their shields, because... Well, did we have other shields? It was the weight of our shields that was the problem that was stopping us from using a decent one in those catacombs previously. It wasn't the fact that we don't have 100% damage shields. Just a lack of endurance. You can have a bit of the old bumhole. I like the way it kind of staggers nearby enemies when you crit another one. It's like he's just gone. Jesus Christ, what's he doing to Terry? And there we go. Great shield, ashes, is exactly what I was after from this area. Hopefully we've got the glove warts we need. Although we did pick up the bell bearing for glove wart 1 to 3, didn't we? Given as we're here, we may as well fight the mimics. It's just around the corner. Surprise, lady. And your mimic friend. Hi, friend. Gotta be polite to them when they're basically you. Now, where's our dragon seal? There it is. Yeah, your armor's not so hot against this, is it? Wow. Yeah, we should be using that more. Trying to throw at me there. Have we got something equipped that I forgot about? Oops. Or are you just generally tossing rocks at us because that's your only option? Agile, I'll give you that. Yeah, that unblockable blade is pretty cool. All told. Precious vigor. Now, what have we got? Glove wart 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Nice. So we don't need to buy any glove wart right now, but before I forget, I'll drop off the bell bearing. So we've got smithing stones 3 and 4 on our bell bearings, but we haven't got stones 1 and 2. Curious. I mean, it's all about the sombers for Lulu anyway, so... A mere curiosity, nothing more. Now, how much is it going to cost to upgrade our soldiers? Not a lot. I'm surprised we could afford all that without having to pop any runes, but that's the case. And now we can go and look at Leyndell. So we've already got big drifts of sand or ash, whatever this might be. Even up here. And one of those horn boys tootling away. So yeah, something big hit that wall. Cannon? It doesn't look melted, so it doesn't look like a dragon of some sort. Giant ballista of some sort, maybe? Oh, is that the door into the Erd Tree? It might be. Yeah, there's a split in it there. So we could head into the Erd Tree itself over there. That's kind of cool. No sign of Bok, but... Hey-ho. And then, yeah. This will never fail to be impressive. So, we know... that we can do the old jump down there and down here, and we can get to the shortcut pretty quickly, which is fine. We'll pop back up probably because we do want to pick up the seedbed curse, I think, and then speak to Dung Eater about that. For now, where was the entrance to the shortcut? Is it just this room here that we're stood on top of? Yeah, there's our Crucible Knight friend who we're probably not going to bother. Although, that rune they're guarding is worth like 50,000 runes, I think. But I don't think we even need to fight them. Per se. We've got the shortcut open. We could just race in, grab the rune, and then bugger off again. Excuse us. Yep, here is rune 5. Okay, it's not the Lord's rune, I thought it was. It's pretty cool nonetheless. Now, can we persuade you to follow us? And then can we make you fall down a hole? Or have you gone as far as you're willing to? Yeah, you really don't seem to want to come any further, do you? Ouch. So it's entirely possible to cheese you, I think. Maybe if we can get a shot. Yeah. I don't even know. You'll probably respawn, though. So there's probably no point to doing this. Oops. Yeah, you do your weird bullshit attacks, that's fine. Okay, now where have you gone? Ouch. Yeah, we kind of asked for that. Is the rock going to finish you off? I do hope so. Hey. But now that we've killed you, let's see if you do actually respawn.